I'm fitting this air-to-air mini-split heat pump into my house because I'm so bored of the negativity that's surrounding heat pumps. Installed correctly, any heat pump can be an effective and cost-effective way of heating your home. Pictured here is the type of air source heat pump that I normally fit in new houses. Basically, it comprises of two units, the outdoor unit and the indoor unit. This picture is quite deceptive. This unit is actually about a metre high, 1.5 metres long and 500 mil deep. The indoor unit here is a cylinder with an inbuilt buffer tank. The water heated by the external heat pump is transferred to the buffer tank. From the buffer tank, it's distributed to wherever it's required by various valves and pumps. This video is showing the basics of me installing what they call a mini split heat pump or air conditioner. This is an air-to-air heat pump and it comprises of an indoor unit and an outdoor unit. I'm going to fit the indoor unit above my front door as indicated here. Both indoor and outdoor units are individually boxed. Within the first box I open is the outdoor unit with a 3 meter pipe set for the installation. In the next box is the inside unit that comes with 1.5 meters of pipe work attached, the main supply cable and the power and signal cable that goes from the indoor unit to the outdoor unit. Also is the condenser pipe that's attached to it as well. There is also the unit's control, remote control and full instructions. At this point, I'd just like to say that this is by no means a textbook installation. I fulfill the installation requirements in some places and not in others. This is by far and by no means an installation instruction video on how to install one of these units. After deciding to mount the indoor unit above the front door, I realised it's not practical for me to take the pipework out through the outside wall behind the indoor unit. So the pipework and the associated cables have all got to travel down through this cupboard, which as you can see contains the boiler and all the associated bits and pieces. I decide to run the pipework and the cable down in an existing boxing. I'm running the pipework and cables down inside this cupboard because the installation is on the front of the house and this will lessen the visual impact of the cables and pipework. After unpacking the inside unit, the first thing to do is to mark the bracket position on the wall. With this particular unit, there is no template, so it's just a case of measuring it and measuring it again. Beware, above all doors and windows there will be a lintel. This will make drilling a little bit harder. Also, you can't drill large holes through lintels because you will compromise their structural integrity. So be cautious. Unfortunately, nothing's ever 100% level. So sometimes it's just a case of doing something that's pleasing to the eye, within reason. Once I'm happy with the position of the bracket and that the screw holes are level, I drill and plug the holes. After marking it out, I just go ahead and cut the channel in the plasterboard boxing. By not doing too much damage and cutting it reasonably well, it should be quite easy to make good afterwards. I go ahead and fix the wall bracket with 4 or 5 screws. There's not a lot of weight in the indoor unit, but just in case somebody decides to swing on it, we don't want it coming down. to make the hole from the hallway in through the cupboard, I just use a 75mm hole saw. As the pipe works coming out of the unit on the left hand side, you have to remove a few blanks in order to channel the pipe work through. Then it's just a case of threading the pipes through the hole and then lifting the unit up onto the bracket. After a bit of persuasion, it goes on quite easily and hooks over. It just hooks over, it doesn't fix in any other way other than just hooking and then just clipping into place. I put a mark on the wall to use as a reference so that I would know that the indoor unit was located completely on the bracket. This small piece of wall wasn't completely flat, so I had to do a few minor adjustments to the bracket so that it would hook over. Once I was happy that it wasn't just going to fall on the floor the minute I turned my back, I removed the rest of the protective packaging. I'm installing this heat pump to augment our existing gas central heating. We live in a three-storey townhouse. The ground floor is heated by underfloor heating and the two remaining floors are via radiators and towel rails. Because this system is more or less instantaneous, gives off the heat instantaneously, I'm hoping that it will increase our comfort levels and possibly reduce our gas bill and carbon footprint, if you like. Prior to taking the outside unit actually outside, I decided I would remove the cover and the packaging and just familiarize myself with all the connections, electrical and the refrigerant connections. The electrical connections on this unit are pretty simple. Basically, the inside unit feeds the outside unit via a normal 3-pin outlet. At this point, I've already drilled the hole through the outer brickwork using a 78mm core bit. Here I'm unpacking a vacuum pump and gauge set and hoses that I purchased from Amazon at a very good Black Friday price. With this split system, you don't need to pull a vacuum on the pipework. The instructions cover both scenarios, whether you have a vacuum pump or decide not to use a vacuum pump. As I said, I got the vacuum pump and the kit at a very good price, and it's done the job that I required of it perfectly. There are no special qualifications required to fit this mini split system, as the refrigerant is R290. This has a very low GWP. I connected the hoses from the back vacuum pump and pulled a vacuum down to negative 30. After the vacuum had been pulled for 30 minutes, I turned off the vacuum pump. Just for my own peace of mind, I let the vacuum stand in the pipe overnight. The following morning, satisfied there were no leaks, I let the refrigerant into the system and checked all joints with leak detection fluid. So here, after making good, this shows where the pipework travels from the inside of the building to the outside of the building. Here's the outdoor unit in position. As you can see, it's not textbook distance away from the wall, and there's an obstruction in front of it, but it works perfectly. I'm really pleased so far with the heat pump. It's made a huge difference to our comfort levels, and it also influences the thermostat on the ground floor for the underfloor heating and the thermostat on the middle floor for the radiators. Basically, this culminates in the fact that we're not using as much gas to heat our house. Now, you might argue that we're using electricity instead of gas. I have cautiously calculated over a 10-day period. Our overall gas usage is down by £12.70. Our electricity consumption for these 10 days is approximately £4 over and above our usual usage. That's an overall saving of £8 over 10 days. Plus, our comfort levels are much better than they were. Over this 10-day period, the COP of the air source heat pump has been approximately 6, which I know it's mild at the moment outside, but that's still excellent and still much cheaper than gas per kilowatt. Of course, as the outside temperature drops, so will the COP. So here is an example of today's COP with the outside temperature being 6 degrees C. Today being the 13th of December 2023.